2012 promises to be just as crazy as 2011 for big and small businesses. Brands and businesses have so many new mediums to connect with customers. Reed Stone, founder of the Hero Farm Marketing Group, is here with more on where to focus and the 2012 trends in marketing. Reed, thanks for joining us this morning after the biggest game in college football history. I appreciate it. But we're looking ahead to the year ahead. And what sort of business trends might small businesses look toward to try and capitalize on?
Sure. Well, the first and foremost thing is mobile. Around the Christmas holiday, there were some 7 million Android and iOS, Apple iPhone devices activated. And between Christmas 2011 and New Year's Eve, there were somewhere in the neighborhood of 1 billion apps downloaded. And so the biggest thing that a small to medium-sized business, or even a bigger business, a local business, can do is really see how it is that their consumers are interacting with their brand online. What terms are they searching for? Is their site showing up the right way on this small screen? You know, what is the path that people are taking, and you know, how are you reacting to it?
Do we have any stats as to how many how much in sales may be driven by apps these days, or is it all anecdotal at this point? Everybody's on them constantly, and everybody is aware of the power of that device.
Well, and that's probably the one big thing I would say is that, you know, the fact that you're just constantly staying in front of them. There is a stat that says somewhere in the neighborhood of, you know, 53-54% of people who are engaging in social media end up having a more positive response. And so there is a little bit of actual data there, but it kind of varies by industry. And so the best thing we can tell people is, you know, now that all these different sites and all these new apps have come out, how, you know, find where it is that you're fitting in there. So whereas, you know, 2010, 2011, Facebook and Twitter were these huge things, and now they've kind of become a customer service staple. For 2012, look at sites like Instagram or Pinterest, where, you know, Instagram is one that's, it's more of an interaction site with pictures, and Pinterest is one where, you know, you mark things that are interesting just across the web and then you share it with people. These are sites that have yet to kind of be fully utilized, and for people that are on that Facebook and Twitter overload, that might be a good spot. If you're, you know, your consumer is using these kind of sites, explore them, use them. The other thing I was going to add to that was the fact that, you know, it's actually become easy to build your own app now. For, I think, less than $200, you can go to a site called Business Apps, and they'll actually let you create your own and serve it up online. We've done quite a few in the last year, and so that's definitely our little trade secret there.
I mean, it is so important to anyone's business mix these days. Is there a downside to trying to do it yourself?
You know, the biggest downside in any small, mid-sized business, I'll tell you, is the time. It takes time to constantly be active, constantly be developing new things and trying out the new mediums. But the one thing I tell you is it does pay off. There is something to being that first mover status, and especially if you are a small, mid-sized business, the fact that you are small is probably the best thing you've got going for you. So, you know, if there's another Anthony Weiner-esque, you know, scandal that goes on and you sell pants, well, let me tell you, that is your time to shine. You know, do a promotion, something around it. You know, say anything that you come up with. The more creative you can be and the faster you can move, the better.
Well, in addition to familiarity with digital mediums, what other marketing skills do small business owners often find themselves in need of?
Well, you know, one of the biggest things we tell people is be creative. And it sounds like something that's so easy, but we get so mired in our daily emails and our daily grind, our daily processes, that very rarely do we step back and go, wow, you know, my competitor's doing this, I didn't even think about that. Or I could be you know, using this right here and completely blow them out of the water. And it's just one of those things, you kind of have to step back. And then the other thing is, you know, the value of a good idea coupled with the value of a press release. You know, press releases are still free to write and send out, and so few people are using them because they're so focused on these new mediums. The old mediums are still alive and well.
And with email, they're easier to send out than ever before.
Absolutely, too. Absolutely.
Very good. Food for thought, Reed Stone, founder of Hero Farm Marketing. Appreciate you sharing it with us this morning.
Absolutely. Thanks for having me.
Have a great day.